Hello, Father George Saltzman of the Harvard Catholic Center. We're here in the sanctuary of St. Paul's Church, right by the altar of Reserve, where we have the Blessed Sacrament. And, 40 days after Easter is the Ascension, 50 days is Pentecost, and 60 days is the Feast of Corpus Christi. That's coming up to celebrate. And I wanted us to reflect on that. If I could start in this way, that people often think about the gap of Scripture of their lives, and we had during COVID a great number of groups getting together on Zoom to reflect on Scripture and to pray. And those were very powerful and extremely helpful. And every Mass we have is a Scripture group, really begins with Scripture and commentary on it. And yet it doesn't end with that, because our Lord said, do this in remembrance of me. And so we have the Eucharist, the Lord's Supper, the Mass. And then we also, communion we have left over, we reserve to take for those who are dying or those who are sick. Those who are dying, we call a viaticum, food for the journey. And of course, it's not only food for the journey going to heaven at the end of life, but food for the journey all the way through life. And Christ gives us not simply his example, not simply his teaching, not simply his advice, but Christ gives us in the Eucharist himself. What a remarkable gift. And how important to think about that and reflect on that and then take advantage of that by coming to church every Sunday for Mass and for the Sacred Eucharist. You know, during COVID, we had benediction every week, and it was very powerful. People coming, grad students, undergraduates, coming benediction every single week, and a chance to pray and to be with God. It's a marvelous thing as a Catholic to be able to go by a church and walk inside and see the tabernacle lamp lit and know that the Eucharist is present in the tabernacle, and to pray. There's a Protestant minister who said, if we believe what you believe, that Christ is in the tabernacle, of course in sacramental form to be sure, we crawl up the aisle on our hands and knees. And of course that's what we do when we come into church. We genuflect, we become aware, certainly the Lord is present everywhere, but particularly the Eucharistic presence of the Lord sacramentally, where his real presence, body and blood, soul and divinity, and to trust in God to unload our hearts, and then in Mass to receive him ourselves. So this great feast of Corpus Christi reminds us once again of Christ's gift of himself. If I could suggest, since you have summer free and you don't know what to do, looking up St. Thomas Aquinas' hymns, like Ponce in Lingua Gloriosi, we know the other benediction hymns we think of, Tantum Ergo and O Salutaris. If you want to look up those, what you remember, and the English translations, and think of their marvelous poetry and reminding us and telling us and helping us look at all the different angles and the depth and the breadth and the height and the width and the beauty of God's gift of himself in Christ and Christ's gift of himself at the Last Supper and on Calvary, in the Eucharist throughout time, in every place, in every age. May God bless you.